I'm Bishop Tony Caldwell with the Justice Center. And apparently last night, as you know, we've had a mass shooting out here, which is ridiculous, especially since we already pre-knew that this was gonna happen. And we kind of put the word out and asked for assistance and help, and we received none. You know, we know they have the sideshows and the guys doing the donuts and things of that nature on the weekends. And we had a safe environment for them to be at, but unfortunately, some of our city officials didn't want that to happen that way. And now this is what has happened today. When something can be prevented and we change gears because of political, that's a problem. A lot of these things, we already know the people that's in the streets. We see this every day. We know who's gonna kill who ahead of time. And we reach out for that to get that information to the right hands. And when it doesn't happen or when they don't act on it, this is exactly what we have here today. This could have been prevented right here. We had a summit that we were planning for this weekend, but because of some other political thing, it didn't happen. And we knew this was going to happen if the summit didn't take care of it, if it didn't happen. And exactly, this is it. We have to do better in Kansas City, our community leaders and working with each other, our city officials with our grassroots organizations. The time for this posturing is over. We got babies losing their lives. We got women losing their lives. A young man that was just at one of our sideshow, one of the Smoke Your Tires and Not Your Homies, one of our twins, a good friend of mine, just lost his life. Then they turn around and set him on fire. What is this going on? We had women being set on fire just a few years ago. What is it going to take for us as a community to come together and say enough is enough and quit playing politics, quit playing with these political words and stop it? I'm even going to reach out to the media. I know I'm getting in trouble here. But even with this, when we have certain events, we need the media to lead on some of these events. What I mean by lead is someone on the positive things. Because more positive go out than less negative, people start changing their mindset and start seeing that. So I'm asking everyone here in Kansas City, let's stop doing business as usual, stop turning the blind eye, and let's start getting involved on the real way. Not just saying it, but let's start hitting the streets. Some of these guys out here, they hit the streets every day. This is what pisses me off. This one here could have been prevented, period. And it wasn't.
Can you tell us more about that summit and the decision to change those plans?
The summit was set at the Justice Center. We'd asked for some of the community leaders and some of the city officials because of some of the gangs that we already knew that were already beefing to be there. We heard excuse after excuse after excuse after excuse. We had already pushed it back two times before. These are young people that we've reached out to years ago. They've now changed their lives, and some of them they haven't, some of them have. But the problem is when we say we're gonna do something, we need to be about it. A few years ago, we had a summit and we told the kids, if y'all stop killing, y'all stop selling drugs, y'all stop doing this, we'll get y'all jobs, we'll do this. They stopped. Guess what happened? No jobs, no education. So what did they do? They went right back to the same old, same old. We can't promise them something and not deliver. We have to start delivering on our promises, or this is what happens. This is exactly what happened.
What were some of those excuses or what prevented this from happening?
Too short of a notice. I didn't get the notice. And we see the emails going backwards and forth, knowing that's not true. When we start planning something a month ahead of time, I don't care if you got a notice 4 hours before somebody's getting ready to lose their life. What's more important, going to shake hands and kiss babies or saving a life? That's what we got to get back to, seriously. Let's start saving lives and stop photo opping.
What can you tell us about what happened last night? Do you think it's related to the gangs that you were hoping to help?
I already know some of it is. I can't speak to it specifically because it's still an ongoing investigation, but I know it is because we were already contacted about it beforehand. You know, I got the emails in my phone. We were just talking about it 2 days ago. And the promises that was going to happen happen. That's what pisses me off. When you know something's going to happen. If you knew somebody's coming to your house at a certain time point, was going to break in and hurt somebody in your house, and you call the people that's supposed to be in charge of that, and they don't show up or they don't do anything about it, and it happens, then we got an issue. We got an issue. You have people out here that are boots on the ground. That's what I'm saying. You got people to hear that have the communication. They're not sitting in the office. I'm not knocking nobody sits in the office. Everybody has their part to play. That's what I'm saying. We need to start playing our part and stop ignoring the next person beside us. That's what really has to happen.
What was your initial reaction after finding out last night that 6 people were injured, or maybe this morning?
Well, there's about 4 holes in my wall at home. That was my initial reaction. Knowing that we could have done better. Literally. Knowing that, and all the people that know me know that we've been out here for years doing this, and we've been seeing it time in and time in and time and again. It gets worrying. It gets tiresome knowing that something can be prevented and we don't do anything about it. That hurts. It almost makes you want to throw your hands up or start doing things differently ourselves. Now it's time for us to start doing things differently. It's time for us to start working together instead of just talking about it. We got to work together and make it happen.
How do you go about doing that? What's next?
What's next? I'm going to ask those same young people that were willing to come to the table, to come back to the table, if they would. And I'm going to put my word out there, not nobody else's. I'm going to stand on mine. And I'm going to offer them what I can and what we can as a group. Because that's all we have to depend on, is us. And if that's it, that's it. If we can just say, hey, 3 jobs, and that's it. That's all we can do is 3 jobs. But that's the start. It's not going to change a lot because it didn't get this way overnight. But it can change one life. If one life is saved, it's all that matters. One life. I know a lot of parents will want to go back and say, guess what? My baby didn't die tonight. My kids were able to go outside and play. Now, I've seen a lot of y'all for many years. Now, you think about this. Here it is. Remember when we met compared to now? That's a giant difference to what's going on in these streets today. Remember that. We need to go back to being able to your kids playing outside, sleeping in their beds at night, sleeping on the couch and not thinking about a bullet coming through the wall and hitting them. What is this that our city's come to? We got to do better. We have to do better. We have to cross the ethnic backgrounds, the denominations of the churches, the political backgrounds. Bullets does not have a designation of just one group or one type of individual. It doesn't. You know, we work with the nation. We work with the streets. We work with everybody. Because guess what? We're all affected. I've lost 3 kids within the last 5 years. I am so pissed behind this. It's ridiculous. So if we can't get it together, I don't know what we can do. I don't know.
Yes. Who dropped the ball on this one, Tony?
Yeah. Did the police know about this too? That there was going to be an event last night where something like this was going to happen?
I would say
yes.
I let Dez say that because I'm too pissed right now. Because what I want to say is going to be.
I most definitely would say yes.
Desmond, can we have you say your name before you start?
Desmond Logan, D-E-S-M-O-U-N-D.
Logan, L-O-G-A-N?
L-O-G-A-N.
Go ahead.
So police knew about it. Absolutely.
The police knew about it. What we've been trying to do is work with the police to try to stop the illegal sideshows so a lot of lives won't be in jeopardy. We know that these sideshows go on, and what I've been trying to do since 2017, when we was on 59th and Prospect, when we had no violence, no shootings, we thought that the city of Kansas City would get behind us to try to help us get somewhere to get a sanctioned place to where we can make it safe. We end up doing that down at the Justice Center on 31st and Purcell. We had 2 very successful shows. Everybody was safe. We did a whole lot for the community. We gave bikes away, we raffled cars off. We had insurance, we had barricades, we had food vendors. We had people down there to help you pay your bills. So we just had a lot of stuff going on, and we just thought once they seen it, that they'd jump behind and say, hey, let's get behind them and help them. They knew about this. They know about it every weekend. If you ride around the streets, you see nothing but these marks because they have nowhere to do it. The Heart of America Bridge, 18th and Vine, downtown, 71, 435. They shutting highways down now. All we trying to do is just get them a safe place to do it. And everybody has like been turning like I'm out here trying to have a shooting range around here. I've been fighting since 2017 to get this done. 2017, everybody know I've been down to every official office down there. Some of y'all done covered some of the stories. And nothing. People still dying. And it's just simple. Just give us somewhere to do it so we can protect the people. So now you have people who've seen what we can do, and now they interested in the sideshow, so now they start coming out to illegal sideshows, because as soon as we started a grand opening, then we have to have a grand closing because we don't have enough people. So now I'm trying to do a fundraiser. We got to take the show on the road. We have to leave our city to go make some money, to come back and build something that we can get done here. I shouldn't have to leave my city to go make some money to come back to Kansas City to build something to protect my people. But everybody has the same problem. Texas, Atlanta, every major city has the same problem. And we have a solution. And if it takes me to go out and hit all these different cities during the winter months to make them aware, that's what I'm gonna do. If I gotta go out and leave my city to come back and build something because the city officials won't help me, they done got me off into politics. I done helped, I done worked a lot of polls, done helped get a lot of people in. I ain't gonna mention no names, but then as soon as they get in, I can't even call them now.
Right.
I can't even get a meeting with them now. They won't even come to the shows. So I'm a little mad. No, I'm a lot of mad. Because what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to grab the next potential shooter. 16 on down. We trying to grab them. Because those are our next shooters. If we don't do something and become role models and get the community to stand up and grab these little ones, well, we're going to have an even worse problem, because the only people they got to look up to is these guys doing the shooting. These guys doing all these illegal sideshows. That's what they looking up to. So if you think it's worse now, next 5 years is going to be total chaos. But if we don't stand up and do something now, and if the kids don't see that the city is trying to help them now, we going to have more violence. Now, I'm not saying that I can stop the violence, but we can slow it down. We can start having more positive role models up on stage speaking to them. So we just trying to get more people to come out, and we give them a platform. We don't just do donuts. We have kids out there performing. We have speakers out there talking. We don't have nothing like that. And as it seems, I'm the only one, along with all of these people, that's trying to put it together with the Justice Center and everybody, trying to put something together to where we can slow down the violence, to where my kids can have a future. Other than that, we all sitting targets, because everybody feel like it's not happening in their neighborhood. It don't matter. But when they get to shooting, it don't matter where you at. They don't aim. They not aiming, so you just ready to catch your own stray bullet. When you see that all these people, most of these people that's getting shot, I'm pretty sure all seven people, or eight, six people that got shot, I'm pretty sure neither one of them was a target. Pretty sure of that. But it's innocent lives. And yes, I can go on record saying the police knew about. I can say that, and y'all can quote me on that, whatever you gotta do, because I know that they know. Now, why they didn't come try to stop none of it, I don't know.
Desmond, this has been an exceptionally violent summer, and it sounds like part of what you're saying is that because there's not places for people to gather, there's not outlets like yours, that people are sort of forming their own, and that's kind of where the problem starts in a way.
Yes, because we started in 2017, and it was beautiful, and then they stopped it. So they continued on to take it into the streets. And nobody's trying to do nothing. Nobody. Like, the police ain't doing nothing. They know exactly where they put out a list where they gonna be on the internet. This is not, you know what I'm saying? They put out a list where they're gonna be. The police follow them on social media. The police can stop every last sideshow, illegal sideshow. They can stop every last one of them if they wanted to. They don't.
Hell, they shut yours down.
Now, see, this is the killing part with me. I've been trying to do it legally since 2017. legally, complying with everything. They make it so hard for me to get it done legally. They just let all the illegal stuff go. So it's like, sometimes I think, well, maybe I should just go ahead and join them. Because it seems like they're having more fun, because when they come and shut down theirs, they just throw their sirens and now they alone. When they come to my legit side shows, they pull up and I have to go to jail. I have to go to jail because I try to gather people to stop the violence. Now, does that make sense to any of y'all?
How do you think they should respond? You know, you see some people saying, well, they should close Swope Park at night, but then you have events like skate nights or other events that bring the community together safely.
Well, you
is
didn't
it a matter of security measures that maybe you take in your event?
I'm going to speak to that because we have a plan in place. And I'm going to ask you this. Even the plan, I'm going to ask you as a question. Ready? Where's the closest bowling alley around here?
None.
Movie theater, arcade, anything that they can gather at. It's none on the inner city. That's a problem. The Bible even speaks to it, if you leave a child to their own devices, what's going to happen? They're going to create something. So if we don't create things for them positive, this is what happens. Now, even with the sideshow, the Smoke Your Tires, Not Your Homies, I was a little skeptical at first. I was. I'm not going to lie. But as I saw the measures that were put in place, $10 million insurance policy. Never heard of that before. But he met it. He did it.
Concrete barriers
all the way around. Met it. Did it. Never seen that before on any event. When the people even came in, everybody had to come in one way, get out of their car. Their cars were searched from bottom to top, underneath the trunk, underneath tires. Everybody was patted down. No guns, no liquor, no drugs was allowed into the event at all. That was the safest event. I had older people saying, I've never felt this safe before in my life. If you know that everybody is being searched, everything has been taken off of everybody, and you want to turn that down, that's a problem. That's a serious problem. So yes, we need to have more positive things for not only the youth, for our adults. We have to have educational programs, jobs. Those have to be put in place. Nobody woke up this morning saying, hey, I'm going to go out and sell drugs. No, I got to go make this light bill money. But the best way I can do it is by selling drugs or doing this. We need to offer them alternatives instead of just being closed-minded and saying they're going to stop immediately, because it's not going to happen. They need to eat. We all need to eat. We all need shelter. Let's get real about the whole thing. That's the problem. We're not getting real about it. We're just a lot of agencies and groups, what they're doing, they're just trying to keep the numbers so they can keep their figures up and the financials coming into the office, and that's it. But let's do something effective. And stop playing with the numbers.
Right. Let me, first of all, I want to go ahead and close this. I want to say to the families who were victims last night of the shootings, we definitely are sympathetic to what happened last night. I just want to say, you know, there's an election coming up in November. And back in 1996, the legislators down in Jeff City passed a law to allow young people to carry guns at the age of 18. Young people, and I remember during the midnight hours, Alvin Brooks at that time was trying to get people to go down to Jeff City so they can hold this up in session. Unfortunately, that didn't happen. They passed a law to where 18-year-old now can carry AK-47s. And what happens from that? That concerns the police department, and the police department's been doing injury and killing black people, but it's more reprehensible when we see it, when we do it to each other. And so what happens, you got 18-year-olds, I got a 5-year-old. That's like giving my 5-year-old a pistol. We got 18-year-olds with no training, no only an ID to get a weapon. So how can they deal with conflict? And the police are concerned, rightfully so. You got kids with guns, and we're for the last 3 or 4 months, we've been rallying against the police, beating up the police, rightfully so. Rightfully so. Black Lives Matter has become a phrase, a convenient phrase of Black Lives Matter, and that means nothing. All across the city, in Chicago, crime rate has swelled. The president sent 200 federal agents here to this city. And we had this action last night. Where was the police? Well, hell, if we've been beating up the police, the police don't want to come. They come when they're called. They come when they're called. And yes, the police, I was on the news for 3 weeks ago, talking about a police that kicked somebody, a kid, 15-year-old kid, his kid's teeth in. And here we're shooting kids, killing them. It's more reprehensible when we do this. So what I'm saying is that we got this is a reaction and the cause of legislators down in Jeff City. This violence, this blood is on your hands because you introduced this. You introduced this bill to allow 18-year-olds to get an AK-47. Mm-hmm. An AK-47, an 18-year-old that probably didn't even graduate. Splitting burbs and a weapon. So this is the cause. So what I'm saying to my community, vote, get these people out of office. Vote, because we gotta change the laws. That's killing us. When you have availability of ammunition. Now those who are popping off their guns, they went to the pawn shop to get ammunition. We gotta stop that. There's no other way other than changing the laws that's been put in place to cause this havoc in our community. It put all of us in danger. 18-year-old in the state of Missouri buying weapons, mass shootings. That's where it comes from. So I'm calling all our representatives. I hope that God allows you to lose some sleep. Because what I saw last night, I thought I was looking at Baghdad, Iraq. High-powered weapons. And what these guys doing, Desmond doing, and they can't get no support. And we got all of this money, hundreds of thousands of dollars, and we can't support a non-traditional activity. This is non-traditional. And so I'm saying to our legislation is that we're gonna get you out of office. We're gonna vote. Register to vote, young people. Vote.
Can you say install your personal
thinking? Ron, R-O-N, Hunt, H-U-N-T. And this is serious. This is, other than this is surface stuff. We got 200 federal agents here. And 6 people got shot last night. What is this all about? What are these federal agents here to do? I see no results from this. They're just wasting taxpayers' money, and there's a deeper hidden problem. They're not funding activities in the urban core.